Hi, I'm Carl Schilling, and I'm the founder and CEO of the Advocacy Network. And for those of you who are familiar, I used to be doing this podcast live at 5 prior to the pandemic. So it's been a little while, and obviously the pandemic changed a lot of things for a lot of people. So we slowed down on that and had to make some changes in everybody. And I know that there's been some really difficult times for a lot of people. So let me start off with, I know that sometimes you have to go through some things. It's like being put in a fire so you could be refined. So I know if you're a small business owner, I know if you're a business owner who relied on foot traffic and restaurants and retail and all kinds of things, I know it's been a struggle and I know it's been tough times. So, but with everything else, while it may never be the normal we used to know, it will go back to some form of normalcy, okay? And it's already doing that. Now, fortunately, when I created Advocacy about 12 or maybe closer to 14 years ago, we were a virtual operation and we were built to actually help people avoid all forms of financial victimization. And those came in a lot of different ways. You know, financial victimization was quite a big thing. So to date, we've saved people closing in on $15 million of potential losses that would have gone directly to financial victimization. And that came from a book I wrote as well called You Might Be Getting Scammed When. And I was very fortunate to be able to help quite a few people in this pathway. So I want to talk to you about the whole idea of Live at 5, which will be every Tuesday and Thursday. I know I did the Tuesday evening one here. I'm going to put this link on for you on Facebook, but I think the Facebook Live didn't really come together. So I spent, you know, 15, 20 minutes on Facebook Live that I don't think happened. So anyway, I'm going to put this link up for everybody, but it'll be every Tuesday evening and Thursday evening at 5 p.m., live at 5. And the whole idea is this. We want to show you a pathway to financial independence, and no gimmicks, no games, no sales manipulation, just solid, good information, things that work, and we know they work. And right before the pandemic, I wrote a book called The Middle Class Millionaire Plan. It was a plan that we had devised to put together to show people in the middle class how they could do things that some of the ultra wealthy and the mass affluent were able to do because they had higher incomes. So we're going to learn all about that. So it's not a matter of having more money to spend. It's a matter of having more income to create bigger wealth opportunities. That's the whole idea. So financial independence simply means this. It means that you can do what you want, go where you want, be who you want, accomplish all the things you would like to do, and you can do so without the fear and concern every moment that you don't have the financial ability to do it. That's financial independence. So it's not about earning a certain amount of money and having a certain number. It's not about being a millionaire, but it's about fulfilling your desires and your goals, but also understanding the real principles and the dynamics that can make you financially independent. Now, before we get started on that, I will tell you this, that we live in a society where 95% of all the people who enter into the fourth quarter of life, let's call that age 60 and on, fourth quarter is an unlimited quarter. We don't know how long fourth quarter is going to be. It's the one quarter. All the other quarters are 20 years long. The fourth quarter is one that could be 40 years long. It could be 50 years long. Nobody knows, okay? So nobody's promised tomorrow. So every day, you know, functionally, you know, but that is the greatest. That's what they call it, the golden years. Those are the periods of time that you have come through this whole travel of life. And certainly you don't have to wait till then to get these things done. But we want to help you with a device so you're not in that 95%, because here's the sad facts. 95% are dead or dead broke. Okay, they're financially, at best, they're financially dependent on organizations, institutions, the church, family, friends, at worst, the government, okay? But the other 5% are financially independent. They can go where they want, do what they want, be who they want, accomplish the things they want, and with no worries and concerns. Now, that should be a much bigger number, but that number has existed for well over 125 years in our country. So our nation has lived with this 95-5 thing for over 125 years, which is absolutely pathetic. Okay, so what we're going to do in our work together is to give you beliefs and values and things that we know work. We know that they will take you on the path to financial independence, okay? And it starts up here, okay? It starts with these acres of diamonds between your ears. It starts with your beliefs and values, your desires, and the things you want to accomplish, okay? So we're going to start off today with a white paper that I call the three great myths about money. Okay, so the three great myths about money. Now, if you'd like to get this white paper, just email me at advocacy, advocacybz, boy zebra, at gmail.com. Just email me, say, Carl, send me the white paper. Like to see it. If you got any questions, that's again, advocacybz at gmail.com. Okay, so here's the three great myths. I'm going to go over them real quick. You can get the rest in the white paper, but if we can eliminate these beliefs in your mind, we can have the first steps towards reaching financial independence, okay? So again, the three great myths are, the first one is money will change my life. Money won't change your life, okay? Money does not change your life. Everybody seems to have that belief that if I just had more money, everything would be great. All the problems in my life would go away. Everything would be tremendous. Because, you know, everybody who has money doesn't have these problems. Just not true. Never been true. Never will be true. Money is not the answer to all. And most people don't even understand the values and what money really is. Okay. Money is an exchange of value. Money is not a piece of paper. It's not a currency. It's not a dollar bill that's got some kind of promise from a government, which is getting weaker and weaker as the time goes on. That's just fiat currency. Money is the actual exchange of value. If I had a cow and it was worth two chickens, and I gave you my cow and you gave me two chickens, then, you know, that would be an exchange of money. Okay. So if the more cows I had, the more value I'd have, the more ability I'd have to barter and get the things I wanted to get. So money is not what everybody thinks it is. And money certainly will never change your life. Okay. The second, great myth, and the second belief that really hampers people from becoming financially independent, kind of assures them being in the 95%, is that I can get rich quick. And the whole idea of financial victimization, the whole idea of a con man, has come from the grifter who's been able to take advantage of people who believe they can get rich quick. Okay, so that simple belief, it's like P.T. Barnum said, there's a sucker born every minute. Sadly, it's true, but the one thing you got to understand, the perpetrator of any financial victimization is the victim. It's not the con man. It's not the person who came and offered you, nothing, and, you know, in exchange for getting all your money for nothing. No, that's not the perpetrator. The perpetrator is the victim themselves, because they tend to believe in some of these other beliefs that are so dangerous for them. Okay, these myths. So you can't believe in these myths. You have to erase them from your mind. You have to get rid of them. Money won't change your life, okay? And get rich quick does not exist. You can't get rich quickly, all right? Sometimes, look, you may you may have a rich relative you didn't know about, okay? Maybe it's doubtful, but occasionally that happens, right? Even a blind squirrel finds an acorn now and then. You may win the lottery, but that's not going to happen unless you invest really, literally tens of thousands of dollars in buying tickets. Okay. Because it's, you just don't win the lottery the first dollar you throw out and win a ticket. Okay. But if you're going to rely on luck and those kind of things, that's the only way you're going to get rich overnight. And those things just, they happen in a tiny vacuum for a tiny, strange, peculiar scenario, but usually you didn't see all the money that was spent before that lottery win. You didn't see all the loss that went into it previously, okay? So there's no such thing as getting rich quick. The last one is a corollary to getting rich quick, and it is the overnight success, Okay, the overnight success does not exist. There's no such thing as an overnight success. And the longer we believe this, the longer we lead ourselves into a fallacy belief that when I don't get it fast enough and I don't become successful quick enough, I move on to the next thing, because an overnight success suggests that I should be successful immediately. But what's missed there is the tens of thousands of hours, the pain, misery, sacrifice, all the things that went into many years, sometimes decades, of practice, of commitment, of making sacrifices to become this overnight success. So, and no one discusses that. That's not what they ask you about when you reach it. They don't ask you, just share with us a little all those years and how you came along and everything you gave up and everything that happened for you to be this success. That's what you should focus on, but most don't. So these three things are the leading factors. These three myths, I can tell you right now, are the leading causative factors for people to end up in the 95% and not have a pathway to financial independence. These three things all alone. If you could evaporate these three simple beliefs and erase them from your mind as if they never existed, you can get started and move to where you want to go. Okay. So remember the three of them. Just erase them from your mind. Remember them long enough to erase them and delete. Get them out of your head, right? Money won't change your life. Get it erased. Okay. The concept and idea that money will change your life. There is no such thing as getting rich quick. I cannot get rich quick. So get it out of your mind, eliminate it, and you will be well down the road to never being victimized. And lastly, there's no such thing as an overnight success. Success takes time, effort, it takes failure. And it takes the ability to either learn from someone else's failure or to effectively use your own failure. Either way, there has to be failure involved, okay? So again, I'm Carl Schilling. It's so great to be back with you again. I'm very excited. And I'm going to meet with you every Tuesday and Thursday at 5. So come on back again. Be here for 5 o'clock of this coming Thursday. I put it out on the Facebook, so we'll see how that all works out. I may start using my YouTube channel instead. So we'll see. We'll see. But as we grow a little and the audience comes together, you'll know where to find me, okay? And advocacy, advocacybz, boy zebra, at gmail.com. Okay. Advocacybiz at gmail.com. Email me, send you the white paper. Okay. Thursday, we're going to do the three golden rules to financial independence. And I'll be glad to email you those white papers. And you can always call me 321-947-3220. Remember, at the end of the day, it's about helping you become financially independent and showing you the pathway to make that happen. So let me be your guide. Trust the fact that I'm going to give you transparent and really clear, concise things that will help you. Okay. Have a great evening. Thanks for your time, and look forward to speaking to you soon. Take care.